Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. We're back here on American Truck Assembly. We're back in the modded profile. Today we've got a modded truck. I got this off of mod sites, ATS mod sites. This is a W990. Kim Murphy announced this truck last year. It's not a bad mod, it does need some work. It doesn't have a lot of customization options. I mean, other than that, I mean, it's not a truck that I would use a lot, but it does look pretty decent. So we're gonna get on the road. We got 365 miles. We're heading out to Albuquerque. We're in New Mexico now, so we're still in the air. So let's get on the road. Has a default dash in it from like the W900 in the like that. Actually has more on the dash of the T680, except for the gauges there. They don't have those. The STS versions don't. I do like the antennas that move right there. That's pretty cool to see the antennas. But here's the interior of the truck. Sleeper. Everything like that. Shifter. Yeah, I mean, it's a work in progress for whoever made it. But it needs some work to get up there. Today the truck's running a Cummins ISX 600, 18-speed Eaton 4 transmission. And our expected time to be there is at 9:30 a.m. So the next trip we will take a look at is going to be the 567 Peterbilt. It's made by GT Mike and his team. So we're on the Sting Workshop. One thing too about this truck is not good on fuel at all. And it has a small fuel tank. You can't change that. That's one thing that I'm not too fond about with the truck. It's not good on fuel. Get on the interstate here. One thing good about being down here in Arizona and New Mexico like this is the speed limit. You're not in California, so you can get up to some speed. Shouldn't be a very long trip. Get some speed out of this trip. There we go. We're getting up right now. really been enjoying the new LSPDFR. I don't know when it's going to come back to the channel though, because I am having some problems with it, so I'm trying to get that stuff situated and fixed before I bring it back, because it wouldn't be right. I'm having some texture problems. I've done everything that they say you should do, and it's still doing it, so I've got to look into find out what's going on. What's going on, reason why I'm losing textures. So I didn't lose textures on the on the old version, so. £71,692. Alright, let's roll. We'll stop right here for a minute. Take a good look at the truck. Not bad. I did remove the traffic mods I was using. I removed Jazzy Cat stuff, but I'm trying to get the stuttering under control on here. And I've heard Jazzy Cat stuff cause some stuttering. So I'm trying to level it off, see if we can figure out what's causing the problem. Alright, we got some fuel, we're ready to go. There we're in there, New Mexico Highway Patrol. Yeah, I did remove, I had the Meatballs traffic mod in, and it was, I thought that may be causing some of the stuttering, so I took it out. It's still doing a little bit. So I'm still trying to track down what mod's causing it. Looking for more to bring to the channel. There's just certain things that I don't play, that I really don't know how to play. But I have been looking at some other things, trying to decide what I want to bring. Finally got it at speed here. Get by this bus. Hopefully I can figure figure out the problem that I'm having with LSPDFR and where I can put it back on the channel, because I am really enjoying the new version of it. It's, they've done it very well, but just something is causing texture issues. I don't know what it is, because they didn't do it before and I'm trying to find it. Early morning traffic. It's about 6:15 a.m. I do like the lollipop lights, like right here. You don't see too many of that, but that's pretty cool. There we go. Still getting a few stutters here and there. I'm still working on it, trying to figure out where it's coming from. This truck's not good on fuel. Yeah, I'm thinking that the mod itself is the cause of the character flaws, because if you play GTA without it, I mean, I'm using real cars in my LSPDFR. I'm not using GTA cars, and yes, real models will make you lose textures, but that's something to do with either Rage plug-in hook or the new LSPDFR1 is causing a problem, because without you running that, it doesn't do it. And it's not bad, but it's more than I want it to be. It's just a little. Thank you. So we're about 195 miles out from our drop. And we're right over this is 4. Hit the sign. Bad driving out there. But it's gonna let it slow. Thank you. Need to pay attention. I do apologize for the absence of not uploading. I've just been busy. Going over the bridge. We've got a realistic fuel assumption, so it should be better now. Just build it up, and it's going to have more when I leave it from there. We'll drop this off. The biggest problem is it has a small gas tank, and it didn't hold much. I think it didn't hold like 100 gallons. We're about 85 miles out from our drop here. I mean, even the SCS trucks are better fuel than this one. This is kind of ridiculous. I didn't know how bad this thing was on fuel. Maybe a trailer pack that come out over to look into that. We're gonna make it there. We're 52 miles out, and we're about to fuel again. It is a mod. It's most definitely a mod. It's called it. I just don't know which one it's called.